Hi, and welcome to this introductory tutorial on MPFB. My name is Joel Palmius, and I am the project manager of the MakeHuman community. In late January 2025, MPFB was finally released as stable. It was then released on Blender's extension platform, making it easily available for anyone with a modern Blender installation. This video will demonstrate the recommended steps for installing and configuring MPFB, as well as the first few steps in creating a character. The first thing we need to do is download and install MPFB from the extension platform. However, in order to do so, we need to enable online access. This is needed in order for you to find MPFB in the first place. Once this has been done, we can go to the extension tab and install MPFB. The next step is to configure where MPFB should store its user data. You can do so in the add-on preferences. This can be any directory you like, but it needs to exist before pointing MPFB at it. This directory is where, for example, asset packs will be installed. Now, before these settings take effect, we need to save the preferences and then restart Blender. Once Blender has been restarted, you should find MPFB on the N shelf. That is, if you do not see it when opening Blender, hit the N key to display the panel with the tabs on the right hand of the window. The next thing we want to do is to install the system asset pack. While MPFB works perfectly fine without this, you will most likely want some skins, clothes, and hairstyles. You can open the Asset Pack's webpage with a button under System and Resources. There are many asset packs to download here. Feel free to pick a few which seems interesting. However, the one we want now is the MakeHuman System Assets. In Blender, we can now go to the Apply Assets and Library Settings panel and find a button for installing the asset pack. Browse to the zip file you downloaded. We are now ready to create the first character. Under New Human and From Scratch, you can select some basic traits. It does not matter much what you choose. All these settings can be changed later on. With the mesh created, we can move on to the model panel and fine-tune the settings of the character, such as weight and muscularity. There are many detailed settings too. Let's just pick one here to demonstrate. We'll find the nose size setting and give the character a large nose. Next, we might want to give the character a skin texture. We can do so under Apply Assets and Skins. Before continuing, we want to give the character a rig. This is because when we add things, such as eyes or clothes, we want these to be rigged automatically. For this demonstration, it does not matter much what you choose here. Now we can start to attach common body parts such as eyes, eyebrows, and eyelashes. We might as well give him some hair too. Maybe we prefer another eye color. Also, we might want some clothes in order to not get banned from YouTube. Now we have a viable character. The next thing I want to demonstrate are the rig helpers. These are IK controls you can add to a default rig in order to make posing easier. With the helpers added, we can enter pose mode and adjust the position of the character's hands. The last part I am going to show is the functionality for saving and loading characters. Obviously, you could simply save the blend file, but MPFB also supports saving character settings so that you can easily add the character in a new scene. Saving the character is done on the manager's save files. With the character saved, we can now delete it and load it back from the new human from save file panel. This concludes the demonstration. There are obviously a lot more things you can do in MPFB. These will be covered in a later video. If you run into trouble, please take a look at the docs, or if that does not help, post a support request on GitHub. Anyway, thank you for watching and happy modeling.